Okay, so with most of it all together, there's a few things left for physics. Not really to do with physics itself, but to do with the items around it. For example, I think I ended with at the end, I'm still using both of the position, both the position map and the pool together right now, when I really want to just use the pool. The only reason I'm still using the position map is because it in order to get rid of the map, I need to make some changes to, I believe it's like the position descriptor pool, this thing, which is using the map to generate position descriptors. So, and then I imagine actually it's probably being used in the application as well. Like if I go for position like that. There's probably another few locations hiding around, like here, yeah, for the descriptor set and stuff for use. Not exactly great, but it's only a few locations. But soon, soon. Okay, so the first part I'm going to have to do is change this up. I need to change this to use a new position thing instead, so. Just kind of put this in the side. What is it? What is it? What is it? It's using. Nope. This position pool like that. Okay. Okay. Copy that. Move over to this side. Right about here. What I want to do. What's going through? It's going through positions. It's going to use that. So what do we I need to do is change it to before I do this, I need to make sure that I actually have like these available. Because right now, I'm only adding this for just the render mesh ID, not the triangle. Is there anything else? Is there anything else with state position? Camera. Okay. So P position equals these two. We do that, and then we're going to do that. Ooh, this is kind of off. I don't like it. Camera ID, amazing. Can I just do this inside of it like that? New position that. Yeah, I can just do that. Okay. This is render triangle dot reset. Copy this. mesh, render triangle, camera ID. Okay. That also means camera, the camera pool, right? This is also using... No, it's not. What's camera using? Or is it just using, is it integrated into camera? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, interesting. Change camera to use 3D. Obviously, I never changed that over from the earlier when camera was not using it. It may be just inheriting it, and then that's kind of it. Where do I specify camera? Yeah, it's just getting the data from that and just going flying off with it. Nothing. Okay, so these should cover all these cases. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to flip back to this. It's going to instead use position pool. At this point, these should be the same, right? Let's just have a little looky-loo. This is taking a while. Oh, I got problems. Oh, yes, I'm not including the new. State.positions2. That's a reference. Okay, size is 3. Positions.size is 3. Perfect. So I can use it. Let's slowly. So position pool, size, that, and that. We're just going to use the entire pool for now. Even if we're not using, camera. Obviously, that's not being used for this purpose, but whatever. So... P data equals P position pool begin 1 star const P end P data n equals okay. For to the end. That's P data. Okay. This becomes P data or in. Right, because it's a pointer. Let's change these up to p data. Get da-da-da-da. Change that up. Change that up. system, does it change this? Yes, it does. It does change both. So, first of all, does it work? Classic. It doesn't. Main loop in here. Why? What's... Yes, because it's using the old map type, not the new type. Okay. One, two, three. That's these ones. That's that. Okay. Okay, if I want to do this, how do I do this? I just kind of, okay. I'm going to, for the moment, assume that we are going to have a valid entity, and then I'm going to just grab it. So, auto plus offset, position offset equals p simulation set state dot positions to dot find entity. Okay. Dot get, not dot point get. Yeah. So it becomes this. Okay. That leaves this position. Okay. What did I just do? This, right? Change it here. Oh, this is so indented that the formatter is trying to keep it under like 120 characters. Right? Yes, 100. Is it 100 or 120? Dot clang format. It's 100. I could probably fit a bit more. But 100's already kind of a lot. Especially like, typically if I'm on the 4K screen and this was not like zoomed like this, I'd be able to put three of these 100 columns each and be just fine. But I'm zoomed in quite a bit for recording purposes. So, not quite. Don't save. Crap! No, that was the fu- oh. Dang it. I was here, right? Yeah. Triangle. What? Whoa! Where am I going? Okay. Stop. Okay, what's left? Let's just kind of do. Where is it? Here. And then we'll just get P position. That is terrible. That's even worse. Ew. Okay. Okay. Terrible, terrible. Here, right? Oh, I see why, because it's not there yet, because it hasn't been entered into. It has it's not gone been through a maintenance cycle, so it's not part of the main pool yet. Let's move this up a little bit. Let's put it like here instead, right? Just here, just because I don't know what I'm doing here. Camera, we do this. That'll be correct. Like that. Yeah. Try that. Can we do the camera? We're good. That just kind of leaves what? Just these, right? If I remove these, then we're all good still, right? No. Oh, here. Don't want position map here. Okay, let's remove it from here, or try to just do this and see what happens. Ooh, it's used everywhere. This is the old one. Don't really care. Then in here, positions removed. And same thing here. That just means if I go into this, get rid of the old map. Also means on the system here, the map's going away before I even have to commit, which is good. Whoa, it's really attempting to load collision shape a lot. As opposed to before, for sure. So that's back down the resource loading, not really being all there. What is this even for? Do I even use this anywhere? No, the answer is no. Okay. So that's a lot better. Let's change over state pools so that it actually says, you know, position. Well, positions two becomes position. That. These are all state, so it becomes rigid. Like that. Okay, I've got more than enough stuff flying about now, and whoop, get rid of that. That all this, or rather we'll add physics by itself, and then we'll add the changes to integrate it in. So this is just physics, right? Yeah. And we'll add this, so after it's built. Just quickly, yep. Should I really add a copyright? No, I don't really care for. Like, if someone really wants to copy the like this, then have at it. This is pointless. These are just all inline. I mean, I guess. Just gonna have that as a little note. I mean, there's basically no real, they're all one-liners anyways. So back to that, inline implementations. It's private to the source. I'll have to do a little bit of cleanup of some things. Oh, the awaiting resources thing. Okay, no. For the, what is it? Awaiting. Characters in this 7 characters. 2 over. Single physics. Ah, oh. There we go. Okay. Now that's in. I can start to focus on some other items to do with physics and all that stuff. So one of the first interesting things I was thinking of was, unfortunately right now, here, and everywhere else I'm using like the position data pool, I need to have like the entire like the full declaration implementation of the data pool carried around with me, which is kind of heavy, or heavier than it needs to be. I don't want to have to bring this on all the headers. I want to just be able to forward declare this. My earlier attempts at forward declaring a templated type did not work. So, what if, okay, we can do this with position, first of all, to start with. Right now, this is kind of just using that just by itself. Okay, let's say we have a 3D pool type. What I was trying to do, what I did before was I kind of like forward declared, or tried to forward declare this, like doing a, using I still need to have because when I tried to use like a struct like this, it would always complain about what if, okay, actually let's actually try this instead. What if I do say struct position 3D pool a public of that? The question becomes, okay, can I just like forward declare that like here and that, and then it'll be fine without necessarily having to have this? I still need data pool for this other one. I could just say, hey, it's a struct, it's a faux position 3D pool. I can't because it needs to be the actual size of the thing here. Okay, wait, hold on. What if, okay, may not be able to do it here. But what about the other locations where I was using it? Primarily in physics. I was including it into the system, right? What if can I do it here? Can I struct? That and do this out of the way, please. How does this work? You okay with that? And then I can oh, in the source side. Wait, hold on. It was fine with that. Oh yeah, because it's yeah. And then I only have to include it in these in here. But I don't need it here. I don't even need that. That's just gone entirely. It's looking actually pretty good. I may be able to skirt around the requirement to have templates just pulled in for everywhere. And I start forward declaring a lot more things. Okay. Okay. Yeah, okay, we got that bug again right there. Okay, position. I'm considering perhaps like segmenting these so they'd be like, you know, you have resource, you have component and system subfolders under these, which is more verbose. So this would become under component, and then that would be under system, and it would be like the physics world simulation system or something like that. That actually, let me adjust this a little bit. Okay. Maybe. You know what? I'll make it more. Yeah, it'll make things more obvious as to where things go and what, how they interact with each other. So instead, these guys are going up here. So yeah, and yeah, okay. So, this is going to component 3D pool. I'd have to do the same thing back here. Oh, it's awful. Position YAML component, YAML resource. You know what? No. We'll move these back. Move these back. I'll just kind of like say like 3D component and 3D pool. You can infer what they are. You know what? I'm not even going to, whatever. I'm just going to fix up the pool stuff. So, I mean, I already have it for resource. And as they expand, it will become tougher and tougher. I don't want to, you know what? I will do it. I'm just going to keep vibrating between two awful positions, and I'm going to go with this position finally. So I'm not going to hex dump. Why would I hex dump this? Right click, new folder, component. Put it in there. This position descriptor pool should be taking in that. Don't actually need to have this here. And that will pull in the 3D one anyways. This still needs it for the moment. Even though basically it's just a pointer collection essentially. Or, I mean, it's not a pointer collection. Obviously the objects are here, but like everything that uses these, like state pools is just basically using it to get pointers to other things. Not actually using it as it is. What position? What the? Really, I have 14 files updated from that. Apparently, I do. Is to wrap. The typical late stage C header mayhem. To help head off the typical Or should I really do it as a class? I think I probably should. Realistically, yes. It needs to be a matching so that MSVC is happy. Fix up that. Reset that. Then we'll go ahead and do the same thing for the rigid body. Put it in there. New rigid body. Oh, yes. We'll do that at the same time. Yeah, that's another one I want to do is that YAML component. Okay, let's just, I don't know why XR camera needs it. Yes, that, okay. So, no, don't need these. Right, no system, nope. Well, actually, yes. That and that. Stage select range. Yes. Stage these selected ranges. Okay, back that out. 3D pool, yes. Component. Change name. Okay, hold on. Oh, what's git log? I need to do a number of quick things. First of all, way up here, I need to get rid of these. Goodbye, and goodbye. Okay, go to application. What's in application? We got rid of this. Stage that. Or this side. Okay, whatever. I'll just add it to here. Don't care. I care about all the other references in here. 3D pool, yes. 3D pool, yes. Component, yes. Fix up that. We're now working on this one. Rigid body. Collision. Sorry. Component. We also need resource. Because collision shape is a resource, it goes in there. We need to do the pool type. You know what, I'm just going to get rid of the I'm just going to get rid of the physics. Really, it's not really. Here we go down to state pools. I'm going to grab that. Okay, so for one, you can forward declare that. So I don't even need to have it here. I don't even need to have this here, or here, this, actually. Wow, this is a whole lot lighter now. Amazing. Now, the only difference here is that it's going to actually need to be here. Oh, sorry, that's not a component, it's a resource. Can change this to be faux rigid body. It's a number of changes, right? Yes, yes. Yes, 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 yes. It in a larger setting for okay. What was that? Change renders, change position in 3D to use new data pool. Yes. Camera to use position 3D. It already is. Render state to new, use the new data pool. That. System has a number of things. One, okay. I don't even need memory. I can get rid of that. As well, I'm just exporting these. Like, do I need in here as well? No. Memory, yes. I can add like a specific log for this. Makes sense. Now I'm just kind of going through and doing minor improvements now. So let's just grab a log from, I think resources got one, right? Yeah. Let's do a very specific one for here. Okay, so this is using this so we can instead of grab just the local log. And instead it becomes, where do we have it? Oh, I just had it here. Well, that's kind of pointless. Get rid of that. Code not required. Okay. The pool? No. The loader? Yes. Question. Do I, because right now if I pull in info log, that automatically gives me the general log. Do I want to actually have this, or do I want to have like info log and info general log to make sure like or do I even like, what if I just get rid of it? So, like, everyone has to declare their own log category. That's fine. In plugin and in log. You know what? I'll actually just do that. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. I swear on me, mom. Or don't, yeah, do that. Faux core. I'm going to call it faux core. Okay. This is going to be painful. There's a lot of items here. Go down to here, okay. Yeah, this is gonna not die out. Right. There we go. Yeah, this is actually a very good thing. Okay, and then this. No, we'll just call this one general. This is the HPP, right? Yeah. Okay, this can be brought in via. Oh, come on. Come on. Save it. Save it. Thank you. Well, we're getting closer. Okay. Undefined. Oh, did I just not add the log graph to group data? Symbol was never built, generated. Okay, we're back on. Okay, that's cute. I understand that. That's another thing I still gotta deal with. What about normally otherwise? Okay, general info, graphics, general VK for physics. Okay. So this is all stuff to do with faux logs. We'll squash that up into the last one. Okay, this has changed up entirely. Nice. Oh, whoops. I didn't actually remove it from here. Okay. I guess an hour 20. Okay, this will be pretty. Okay, I will call it there. I mean, I got physics, it's integrated. I changed over position to the new data pool type. I kind of reorganized things a bit more clear, and I've replaced, kind of fixed up the log to get rid of the general one from per. Proliferating throughout the entirety of the repository in libraries. And instead, each library, if they're going to use a log, they have to have a local one. And the general has been shifted down to this one. Okay, that's it for now. Cheers.